Project Power. Project Power is an action crime and sci-fi genre movie appeal that gives its users unpredictable powers for 5 minutes, hits the streets of New Orleans. A teenage dealer and a local cop must team up with an ex-soldier to take down the group responsible for its creation. Written by Mattison Tomlin and directed by both Henry Joost and Ariel Schulman. Starring Jamie Foxx as Art, Joseph Gordon-Levitt as Frank, and Dominic Fishback as Robert. And if you have not already subscribed to the channel, please make sure you do. Help yourself, help me out, help the channel out. It will be greatly appreciated, and be a part of the conversation that is movies. So, what are my thoughts on Project Power? I have to say this is a movie that does a good job, and it does enough to get itself over the line. And one of the biggest standouts with this movie is its cinematography. New Orleans as a place has so much personality, and you know, from watching the movie, the colours really do pop off the screen. Myself, I have not been to New Orleans, but you know, with the certain shots and scenery, especially the first chase sequence that involves Machine Gun Kelly, you know, the colors are just popping off. It's got this urban feel to it. It feels rich, it feels enlightening, and it really just all of it just pops off the screen really nice. And another thing that really, this is an odd one, what I'm about to say here. Now, I really did appreciate the cinematography in juxtaposition with the hand-to-hand fight scenes, with the action that is in this movie. But it's not so much of a thing of the actual choreograph, the hand, I thought that was as anything we've seen before in terms of action, but in terms of how it's actually shot, the one takes with the dollies and the gimbals, you can really appreciate, because you're watching action that's not giving you a headache. There isn't 51 million different takes between this angle and that angle. And I felt like the cinematography really utilized and allowed the audience to really feel like they are a part of the action. And again, the action itself is like anything we've seen before, but just to have that little bit of reassurance with the one takes makes you really feel the scope of it all. And in particular, one of my favorite scenes in this movie is the ice chamber scene. You know, the one shot. You know, I kind of like the fact that everything kind of felt discombobulated, you know, the confusion as to what is happening in the scene, and then obviously that poor girl and how she ends up succumbing to her demise. And that was all really good. And, it was a kind of scene that was thinking outside the box, and that's why one of the reasons I really did enjoy that. Look, Jamie Foxx, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, they all respectively do well in their roles. They add great camaraderie, they add great levity, they add, it's always just a joy just to see those actors act. And at the main heart of this story is Dominic Fishback's character as Robin. I really did like the fact that they doubled down on her character and really took the time to make her as three-dimensional as possible. It's one of the fundamentals. You're just to even have a enjoyable time with a movie, that's something that has to be there to really root for these characters, to see them obtain their goal, or to see them go through their full cycle of their character arc. You know, the fundamentals of having three-dimensional characters is always a thing. Like, I really like the thing, like, she's into her rap. But at the same time, she's on the streets to sell the pills, and her mum is sick, you know, has diabetes, and it all works well in situ of the story. Now, I'm going to now have to talk about the problems that are with this movie, sadly enough. Now, with every movie, you need an external conflict, and that is Project Power. This organization that is adding this level of unrest within the community, this new drug, and so on and so forth, right? But other than that, the villains are as generic as anything we've ever seen before. They are as generic as a pair of pants. We've seen it time and time and time before. And their ideology gets totally just told in third person. Another crappy campfire story, you know, and it's something I hate seeing in movies. And it, you know, it's almost, I don't know what happens. It's almost like as if the producers kind of know they've let loose on their whole budget on this movie with the special effects and making the protagonists really shine. But at the same time, it feels like they've completely neglected the antagonists. And it's annoying, man. Like, and what can you do? Now, I wanted to talk about Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character. Now, Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character and Jamie Foxx's character, they've got good ideologies. Like, we see Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character that he wants to use the pills in a sense that he doesn't feel safe. He doesn't feel protected by his government. And then we see, obviously, Jamie Foxx's ideology that he wants to take the pills off because obviously he sees damage that it's going to cause for the bigger picture. So you've got these two resting ideologies. And more than anything, I think it worked for Jamie Foxx's character a lot more than it did for Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character. Now, fundamentally, the problem is that kind of goes with how Project Power is written, is that when you take this pill, the catch-22 is that you got 5 minutes and you don't know what power you're gonna get, which adds a level of conflict and adds a level of entertainment. But at the same time, I think there's a deeper layer that you can go within, especially with Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character. Like, if there is a possibility that you can take this pill and you can blow up and be sent back to Narnia, then, you know, this got, you know, why is there not characters within this story that have a little bit of resentment and have a little bit of doubt as to taking it in the first place? Now, when I look at Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character, I think to myself, you could take this and you could just die automatically, right? So, I'm looking at an inner conflict that could make Joseph Gordon-Levitt's character flawed in the sense maybe he's depressed about something, maybe there's something going on in his life, maybe, I don't know, he's got cancer and he knows he's only got an ample amount of time to live and that's why he's taking it, added with the pressure of he doesn't feel protected by his government, which is now leading him to do these very unlikable decisions, but they in somewhat of a way are understandable. And that for me was missing with his character. He had a good ideology, but there was nothing really inner within him or that I could really latch upon a part of his character development. Now, Jamie Foxx, they double down the fact that he is flawed and he has his PTSD, but that for me, it didn't work. I don't know what it was. It didn't reach out and grab me. I don't know what it was. It felt like that part was rushed as well. And another point I'm going to make is that what's interesting is that this film is written by the writer of The Batman, which we'll be seeing next year. Man, I don't even know. From what I've heard, next year, The Batman with Robert Pattinson. Or it might be 2022. I need to check up on that. If anyone can let me know in the comment section whether the Batman's coming out, let me know. But he is the writer of the Batman. Now, I've got to be honest with you. It doesn't look promising if, basically, he didn't, I mean, look, he might be still learning. Look, me, myself as a writer, I'm learning every day about new things, right? But at the moment, I am a little bit worried, you know, the villains weren't three-dimensional. They, you know, no first-person ideologies for the villains, no character development for their villains. You know, and it's got me thinking, like, you know, I don't know, I'm not feeling confident about this Batman movie. But at the same time, he gets his protagonist right. And another factor that we have to bear in mind is that that movie will be co-written alongside Matt Reeves, and Matt Reeves will be directing the Batman. So more, if anything, it's more Matt Reeves' vision. But where I found out that little piece of trivia was from the movie files, from Elliot. So thanks for that, man, if you're watching this. So guys, I'm going to say this. To top it all off, I'm going to be giving Project Power 6.5. It was enough to get itself over the line. I think the movie had good pacing, but it just don't work, you know. But the visuals and the VFX and the CGI, some of the best I've seen from Netflix. So it's kind of a bittersweet movie for me. You know, I really did enjoy it, but I just wanted it to be a little bit better. But guys, thank you for watching. Click here if you want to see more. My most recent movie reviews and TV. You'll see all that. And check the description. And also, please check out my playlist as well, because you'll find everything there as well. Thank you. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace.